Good morning, Farmington. I am Nick Shear.
And I'm Shay Wilkowski.
San Jose Sharks left winger Rafi Torres is being suspended 41 games due to an illegal check to the head. This is not his first encounter with illegal checking. This marks his fifth and most significant suspension for Torres in his 14 years of playing in the National Hockey League. Torres' last infraction resulted from a hit in a postseason game Saturday. He was ejected with 7:15 left in the first period. Torres has been known as the goon of the National Hockey League. He will also forfeit $440,000 in salary for suspensions.
One of the most widely celebrated holidays is quickly approaching us, Halloween. You all know how the U.S. celebrates, but do you know how countries around the world do? In Belgium, they put candles in their windows to celebrate loved ones who have passed. In Sweden, people celebrate from October 31st to November 6th, and they get shortened days of work and school. In France, Halloween is a fairly new tradition, and they celebrate with parties. And in Mexico, it's a joyful holiday to honor the dead with a three-day celebration beginning on October 31st, and it is believed that the dead will return to their homes. Many families make altars and decorate them with candy, photos, flowers, and food. Candles are lit to help the dead find their way back to their homes. And now, our pal Carl has the executive board members of the NHS here to talk about the blood drive.
Good morning, Farmington. I'm here with the NHS Executive Board. Why don't you introduce yourself?
My name is Christian Groves.
I'm Devin Bernou.
So guys, when and where is the blood drive being held?
The FHS blood drive for this fall will be held right here at the high school in the auxiliary gym on Friday, October 23rd.
How old do you have to be to donate?
All 17 and 18-year-olds are allowed to donate, and 16-year-olds are also allowed to donate if they can get their parents' permission.
How could students prepare to donate?
If you're planning on donating, make sure you bring your driver's license. The student IDs are not allowed, so we need your driver's license because it has your photo and your birthday on it.
How does the donation help the Red Cross?
Last year, I think we donated about 90 pints of blood, so this blood helps the hospitals in the ER room or whenever they need blood.
Where do students sign up?
Beginning today at lunches, students are able to sign up for the blood drive, and this will continue through October 14th.
What do you hope to accomplish from this blood drive?
To accomplish for this blood drive, like we said, we want to try to raise more blood than we did last year. I think we raised about 90 pints, so we're trying to get maybe in the hundreds this year.
Thank you for coming down to this too. Now back to Nick at the desk.
Donald Trump still leads the polls in Iowa and New Hampshire. he leads by 5 points over Ben Carson in Iowa. In New Hampshire, it is similarly contested, with Trump leading Carl Fjorn by 5 points again. Ben Carson is falling behind in New Hampshire as he trails Fjorn by 6 points. And do these polls tell us who will win the race? Time will only tell.
Teenagers often think that they are more capable of speeding, following a car too closely, or just trying things behind the wheel that they really shouldn't be doing. New technology in the 2016 Chevy Malibu could give parents of new drivers the ability to supervise and teach their teens before they form bad driving habits. Motor accidents are the leading cause of death for kids in the United States. What the car does is actually pretty cool. The system records distance traveled, maximum speed, when the car had to control and lock brakes, as well as the number of alerts issued by other safety features. Some other things that the car can do is the radio won't turn on until all the seatbelts are on, or parents can also set a lock on how loud the radio will go to make it less of a distraction. You can also set a max speed of the car, where alarms will go off if the speed is passed, but it won't stop the car from going over the speed, but the parent will then get an update saying that the car went over the speed. Overall, this car is to prevent kids from getting in accidents and to lower the death rate from motor vehicle accidents. Speaking of speed, Mr. Mathis gives us a quick tour of this Wednesday's activity fair. Let's take a look. Julian. No, we all look.
Video and Media Club, we do a lot of these sporting events after school and all that, and we're also like going out and having some bowling.
robotics, you should join our team because we make really cool stuff and it's a really cool community. And if you like technology, building stuff, tools, programming, we're the group for you.
Hi, I'm part of the Farmington Esports team. You should join because we are a competitive gaming team that can go for scholarships and different rewards.
Join our group because we like to have fun. We play at basketball games and we're like the heartbeat of everything that's awesome.
We like to make some cool beats.
Yeah, we make noise. It's fun. Don't have to be in band. Don't have to play drums or anything. Just come on out. Have fun.
We're part of a marching band, and one reason you should join marching band is because it's a really good group.
Farmington High School because it helps with your public speaking, debate skills, and we're excited for another fun and successful season.
We are Students for Christ and you should join because we have free donuts and we meet in Miss Lowey's room and she's got a hamster.
Hi, you should join choir because it's a lot of fun to sing and who doesn't love singing, and we do a lot of fun activities like we're going on a choir trip and we go see movies and go bowling and join choir.
I'll be there.
Chapter at Farmington High School, and once a month we support our veterans by hosting a dinner at the local churches.
Bonjour, lycée de Farmington. Hey guys, this is French Club here. We're here to talk about when our next meeting is and what we're focusing on doing. So our next meeting is going to be on the October 13th. It's next week, Tuesday. And then our meetings are usually 3 to 4 o'clock because after school, why not? You don't need to know French. You really don't. We want everybody to join French Club. We want everybody to experience the culture or what we can do. And it's a lot of fun.
So we have our meetings every other week on Tuesdays, and we will occasionally have special events, like not our next meeting, but the one after that on October 27th is going to be a Halloween party, and we're going to have all sorts of fun Halloween-themed games with French. And on November 17th, we will be having a pre-finals yoga de-stressing. We will still be meeting at our normal time, 3 to 4 o'clock. And we just really hope you can come join us. Again, you do not have to speak French at all to be in French Club.
So thank you guys for letting us be a part of the Tiger News. We're having a lot of fun, and I hope to see everybody at French Club next week.
The owner of a Kentucky reptile shop was attacked and crushed by a 125-pound python this past week. The owner, Terry Wilkins, went to go feed the python Monday and was attacked and crushed him. When Wilkins was found, he was no longer breathing. One of the officers uncurled the snake by grabbing its head and freeing Wilkins. Wilkins began breathing again once in the hospital and is now recovering. Animal Control has removed the snake from the shop.
Olivia, a junior at Greenwich High School, was awarded $50,000 in scholarship funds from the 2015 Google Science Fair for her innovation that detects Ebola. Her test only costs $25 per test and can tell if you are infected within 30 minutes. Olivia was inspired after seeing so many people getting sick. She now wants to be a physician, and now we're going to go catch up with our weatherman, Julian Rosoco.
Yeah. What is up, people of Farmington? This is Julian Rosoco reporting the weather. It is currently 49 degrees. It feels like 47. And it's partly cloudy right now. And it's going to be a warm week ahead on the weekend. So for today, partly cloudy, a high of 60, a low of 47, and a 10% chance of rain. And Sunday and Monday are supposed to be sunny, as you might see. Saturday is supposed to be a high of 72 and a low of 54, and it's going to be a bit windy out. Sunday is supposed to be a high of 77 and a low of 59 with a 0% chance of rain. Monday is supposed to be a high of 70, a low of 52, and a 0% chance of rain. And for Tuesday, it's going to be rainy, a high of 67, and a low of 47. Bring your sweatshirts, everyone. And guys, it's kind of hard to breathe up here, but here's my quick news fact. According to NASA and Star Tribune, there was water confirmed on Mars just last week. Star Tribune and NASA says the discovery of water on Mars is a vital need for going to Mars. It's an essential to people surviving on Mars. Shout outs to the table with Lindsay and Kylie. Now back to you guys at the desk.
So are you planning on going to the game tonight?
Yeah, I'm gonna go to the game. I'm gonna be decked out in all my pink, and I got my pink tie. But Sammy Schmitz, a 1999 graduate of Farmington High School, defeated Mark Dole of Lakeland, Florida, 3-2 in the championship match to win the 2015 U.S. Mid-Amateur Open on the 6,885-yard par 72 West Course on John Islands Club in Vero Beach, Florida, yesterday. The pivotal part of the 36-hole battle came when he walked to the tee of the uphill 260-yard par 4 32nd hole with a driver in his hands. Schmitz rifled his driver, which landed on the green 17 feet to the left of the hole and caught the slope in behind the hole and rolled back for an ace, a hole-in-one on a par 4. With a 3-up lead, Schmitz calmly reached the green on the downhill 233-yard par 3 35th hole with a 3-iron. He two-putted to defeat Dole 3-2. Schmitz played his high school golf here at Farmington, but as the champion of the USGA Mid-Am, he was invited to the 2016 Masters in Augusta, Georgia next April. Good job to him and best of luck to him. The football team took on Eagan Wildcats last Friday. It was a tight game throughout the game. Gavin Bassett got the scoring started for the Tigers with a 25-yard touchdown run. Cole Heinrichsen threw two touchdown passes and 259 yards passing and also ran in a touchdown. Hunter Siegler led the way with 7 catches and 168 yards and 2 touchdowns. The Tigers ended up falling short, losing to Eagan 33-42. They take on South tonight at home. It's senior night. Good luck, boys. Volleyball played top-ranked Lakeville South on Tuesday. Here's some action. Emma Fanning with the nice plays hit. Coach Woody liked the way his team was playing against the top-ranked Cougars. Kenzie Hess with another nice placed spike. And after a powerful spike from Lakeville South's player, she digs it up, and Hannah Garski with a nice spike. It was a hard-fought match for the Tigers, and they fought close games and ended up falling 3-1. cross-country boys on Tuesday, they ran at Chaska and got 11 out of 26 teams. Alex Hart finished first with the Tigers, and closely followed him was Derek Cole. The Tigers had a great performance as Lauren Peterson finished second and Anna Finsky finished third. Girls soccer played Hopkins on Saturday and they came out on top 1-0. Shannon McKnight scored for the Tigers. They also got a huge win versus Lakeville South 2-1. Shannon McKnight scored along with a header from Nikki Krebs. They improved their record to 4-7-4. Last night, the girls took on Lakeville North and had a hard-fought game. They ended up losing 1-0. The boys' soccer team also took on North and ended up as a tie, 1-1. And their record is now 4-4. This week, our anchor Shay caught up with Ms. Peterson, a facts teacher at FHS. Let's see what she had to say.
Today I caught up with Ms. Peterson, a facts teacher at Farmington High School. Let's face it, everyone's going to graduate from Farmington, and you're going to have skills to take care of yourself. Ms. Peterson's specialty is teaching kids how to do just that.
There's life beyond high school, and that life is going to require some skills, and you can learn lots of those skills actually through our facts classes. Things are going to take time. They're going to be making some mistakes, and it's okay. You can pick up and move on. And, you know, you have to work hard. Things are part of life, is working hard and figuring things out and practicing and then practicing again.
If you haven't taken a facts class, Ms. Peterson has some reasons why you should.
Learning how to get along and how to function beyond just information and put that in practical use is something that we work on in all the facts classes. We learn things about different roof styles and different house styles, and it's a whole different vocabulary. There's words that you have maybe heard, but you don't really know what they mean. So we learn about them, we study what they mean, and then we actually go see them. We see them on a house, we see them in a neighborhood. We look at all of the styles of the houses, and then we actually look at the interior things at the James J. Hill House, because that's also on Summit Avenue.
In addition to working with the iPad, Ms. Peterson provides experiences that puts things into perspective.
I mean, we do some things with images, and they use their iPads to insert some pictures, but this brings it into proportion. And it's fun, and we spend that time, and we get to know each other a little bit better. And we get to see something that is so close by. St. Paul's not very far away. So it's something that we have right in our back door. But I think it's really good that they have a chance to see that.
Even outside the classroom, Ms. Peterson is still working on her passion.
Oh, well, if I had to narrow down to one thing, I would say to sew. And if I had to go more narrow, I would say to quilt. But I'm a facts teacher. I also love to cook. I also love spending time with my kids. I also love to decorate and to design, but right now my happy place is quilting and sewing, because I get to be creative and I get to design and I get to finish something.
This is Shay Wilkowski reporting for Tiger News.
An Illinois community came together to help a man with terminal cancer harvest 450 acres of corn on Friday, September 25th. 40 neighbors and friends showed up at Carl's farm to help him reap his harvest. They used 10 combines, 12 grain carts, and 16 semi-trucks to harvest the 450 acres of Carl's farm in only 10 hours. Fortunately, Carl was feeling strong enough to go outside and thank all of his neighbors and friends for donating their time and money to help him out. Well, that's it for us, Farmington.
I'm Laube.
I'm Sherry.
And I'm Nick.
This is Junior Rosoco reporting from Tiger News.
Have a good weekend, Farmington. I was so good.